Hi, my name is James Killinan. I am the founder, CEO, and head designer of Killinan Luxury. Today we're going to talk about freshwater pearls versus sea pearls, specifically the Japanese Akoya pearl. We've had a lot of people who ask, what's the difference between these two? Because they look very similar, but boast very different price ranges. So let's dive in. So let's start with origin. 95% of all the freshwater pearls in the world come from China. Specifically, they're grown in the lakes in Juji. Akoya pearls, on the other hand, come from the pearl farms in Japan, and they grow in the ocean. So now that we've clearly established that one grows in the lakes versus the other one is in the ocean, but we should need to understand that the mollusks in which they grow in are completely different. So this is a freshwater mussel. It's capable of growing up to 30 pearls at the same time. However, what we've kind of found is that the fewer that you grow in them, the better chance of getting a higher quality pearl. This, on the other hand, is a Japanese Akoya oyster, which is why we call it the Akoya pearl. This one, if you notice right away, is much smaller than the size of the freshwater mussel. It's only capable of growing one pearl at a time. And the other thing that you'll notice is the size of the oyster or mussel will actually restrict the overall size of the pearl. Akoya pearls are between 3mm and 10mm. Anything over 10mm is extremely valuable. Freshwater pearls are usually between 3mm to 12mm. However, there are some exceptions which are called Edison pearls, but we'll talk more about that later. Next, one of the major differences between freshwater pearls and sea pearls is what's on the inside. So we'll need a few things to start the process. First, what we'll need is mantle tissue from a donor oyster. This is the fleshy meat part from the inside the oyster. Next, what we need is a bead or a nucleus. And what you can see is that they're formed into a round shape, and they're actually cut from a freshwater mollusk. And what this does is this encourages the pearl to also be round. Then if we wait about 1.5 to 2 years, a pearl will form around that nucleus. In freshwater pearls, on the other hand, they require no nucleus at all and only the mantle tissue. What this means is the freshwater pearl tends to be a little bit less round than the sea pearl. However, one of the things we can do is we can tell the difference between them using an X-ray machine. Now let's look at these two different types of pearls together side by side. First, what you'll notice is that the Akoya pearls are much rounder than the freshwater pearls. However, these freshwater pearls are quite high quality and appear to be round. The next thing that you'll notice between these two is that the Akoya pearls' luster is much greater than the freshwater pearls' luster. And so, if you have high quality Akoya pearls, the luster will be unmatched against any other type of pearl. Now, freshwater pearls are dramatically cheaper than your Akoya pearls. They can be 5, 6, even 7 times the price difference between freshwater pearls to Akoya pearls. This price difference comes from location, techniques, survivability of the oyster, labor, and the overall quality of the pearl. Typically, if you're new to buying pearls, then freshwater pearls are a great place to start. They come in at a much cheaper price point, and if you need to, you can always replace them because of the cost. Akoya pearls, on the other hand, are the ones that you usually see on TVs, movies, celebrities. That's the traditional white pearl necklace that you're used to seeing, and it has a long history. So if you're looking for maybe an upgrade for your pearls, or you want something a little more special, high quality, then the Akoya pearl would be the one that you would go with. I really hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please like, share, comment, and subscribe. And then you can see more videos just like this with better content. And you can leave us a comment in the comment section telling us what's the next jewelry video that you'd like to see. I'm James Killinan with Killinan Luxury.